Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Luke. At that time, Jesus came to Jericho and intended to pass through the town. Now a man there named Zacchaeus, who was a chief tax collector and also a wealthy man, was seeking to see who Jesus was, but he could not see him because of the crowd, for he was short of stature. So he ran ahead and climbed a sycamore tree in order to see Jesus, who was about to pass that way. When he reached the place, Jesus looked up and said, "Zacchaeus, come down quickly, for today I must stay at your house." And he came down quickly and received him with joy. When they saw this, they began to grumble, saying, "He has gone to stay at the house of a sinner." But Zacchaeus stood there and said to the Lord, "Behold, half my possessions, Lord, I shall give to the poor. And if I have extorted anything from anyone, I shall repay it four times over." And Jesus said to him, "Today salvation has come to this house, because this man too is a descendant of Abraham. For the Son of Man has come to seek and to save what was lost." My sisters and brothers, the gospel of the Lord. So which of the two scriptures today lifted you up more? Probably a difficult one to hear that apocalyptic style in that first reading, and yet obviously making a strong point. Written to the seven churches in Asia Minor, and written probably right about 50, 60 years after Jesus died and rose from the dead. And in that apocalyptic style that you've seen in some of the other prophets, like going back to the Hebrew scriptures, Daniel, strongly trying to, in a way, shake the people, wake them up from complacency, from sin. And that's what's being said here, because it may not sound like it, but God, working through this vision, loves the people, loves us, but wants to shake us out of sin, out of complacency, out of not really following the life-giving way of Jesus Christ. And scripture passages in that first reading that are worth remembering and reflecting upon. And one of them, this one, I wish you were either cold or hot. So because you are lukewarm, neither hot nor cold, I will spit you out of my mouth. Pretty graphic kind of imagery. But again, it's a reminder for us that if faith is vital to us, if we're here on a morning, then faith has got to be making a difference in our life, shaking us up in a loving way, calling us to not compromise our faith, not to make excuses, not to blame others, but to look at ourselves and say, am I vital in the Lord and for the Lord? Or am I at times lukewarm and I need the Lord to get me going again and maybe challenge me in some way? And then, of course, the other reading, the other passage that also comes, we've probably all seen beautiful pictures. "Behold, I stand at the door and knock. If anyone hears my voice and opens the door, then I will enter his house and dine with him, and he with me." One more reminder that it's up to us. The Lord is knocking at our door every day and saying, "Let me in. I'm here for you." But he can't force us to open the door. We have to open the door from the inside and let him in. So also maybe every day as we go through a day, Lord, to be more attentive, where might the Lord be knocking on my door throughout the day and saying, "Come in, recognize me, follow me, live the gospel values, don't be half-hearted, give yourself wholly to me and to the gospel work." So take a moment. Is he knocking? He may be today. Are we kind of lukewarm that we need to get riled up in a good way so that we can follow the way of the Lord and bring other people the good news of his ultimate love? God bless you.